being a distinct person in society doesn't mean that you're alone in society. Let's expand. Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome. My name is Noah. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. I want to expand on the idea of isolation and being yourself. Because one doesn't have to equal the other. They don't. They're different. Fun fact, this is the ALS sign for different. You're gonna learn so much today. Now, previous videos, we talked about the exact definition of individuality and why it means so much to me. If you guys have not seen those videos, be sure to check them out. They'll be linked down in the description below, just so you can get a little bit better idea of kind of what we're talking about here. Be yourself. Everybody else is already taken. Just be yourself. There's nobody better. You can't change what you are, only what you do. A true test of a man's character is what he does when nobody's watching. Be yourself. Don't take anything from anyone and never let them take you alive. Now, these are some cliche quotes that you may have heard before. If not these exact ones, you probably heard some sort of variant of these in some way, shape, or form. But as cliche and honestly true as they are kind of isolating. I mean, come on. There's no one better when nobody is watching. Never let them take you alive. Let's be honest, these come off as kind of selfish and like lonesome, you know? The reality of it is that being yourself does not have to mean you're cutting off the rest of society. Individuality is about taking your attributes and enhancing them, embracing them. I will be honest with you, the path of individuality may be a difficult one and you may lose people along the way. You may lose some people that you considered to be very, very close to. Some may have even been your best friends, some family members, and in some cases, maybe even a significant other. Now let me explain why the overall quantity of people in your life may decrease. But trust me, there's an upside to this, so like, don't get too bummed out yet. The reason why people may start to look at you different is because you are going to be different. Your relationships may end up taking a hit due to a few reasons. Number one is that you're taking time to find out who you are. Yes, this part is a little bit selfish, it's true. You can't embrace who you are without knowing, well, who you are. Number two is that you won't be doing what the crowd wants you to do. Now this one I can speak from experience. There have been several situations where family and friends have texted me saying, hey, let's do something tonight, you wanna hang out, hey, we're going over to this place, you wanna go get dinner or something. But it also happened to be the same night as my streaming night, which, fun fact, I stream on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday afternoon, 7 PM Eastern Standard Time, linked down in the description. Come hang out with us, it's a blast. Moving on. Now, as inviting as those plans were, and as much fun I could have had, I told myself that I was gonna stick to this schedule. So, unfortunately, I had to turn them down. And number three, the big one, you'll stop living your life trying to please others. In essence, you'll stop being taken advantage of. For example, if someone asks you to go do something, but you really don't want to do it, you don't feel comfortable doing it, then you won't do it. This may cause their perception of you to change. Now, I understand that all of this may come off as a little bit daunting and kind of doom and gloom. Let me explain to you the light at the end of this tunnel, and it is a bright one. The good news is that those who truly care about you, the people who want you to succeed, the people who want you to be happy, the people who respect you as a true individual will stay. These people will be there to support you in this decision making. They will help you on the journey to find out who you are, what you want to do, and where you want to go. Your relationships with your friends, your family, your boyfriend, girlfriend, wife, husband, whoever, will be so much stronger. And you will become so much closer to these people. And again, I can speak from this from experience. I talked about before how I had this group of friends leave me in high school and I felt very alone, but eventually, when I became myself and didn't care what other people thought about me, I pursued who I am. Those same people came back and now our relationships are so much stronger. The gravity pool of like-minded and kind-hearted individuals will be so strong that you'll have people coming back into your life, you'll have new people coming into your life that just mean so much to you and you connect with them on this like interpersonal level that you didn't experience before. Now, yes, the overall quantity of people in your life may decrease, but the quality of the relationships that you have will skyrocket. And that's what's important. Why did I say it like that? having relationships that matter, having people in your life that care about you, having people in your life that want you to be happy. At this point, I think that it's fair to say that being yourself does not lead to isolation. It leads to stronger bonds and connections with humans. Quality over quantity. So don't take anything from anyone, because you can't change what you are, and everyone else is already taken. So be who you are when no one is watching, because there's no one better.